ValiRx said in a second quarter update that it has made good progress on both commercial and scientific fronts. To discuss the progress made by the life sciences company, we are joined by Chief Executive Satu Vainikka, who's on the line. Hello, Satu.
Hi. Hello. How are you doing?
I'm all right. Thank you very much for joining us today. Now, I'd like to start with your lead compound, Val-201, because you said in your update that it continues to perform well and it's phase 1-2, a clinical trial in patients with hormone-resistant prostate cancer. So what exactly do you mean by that?
This particular compound is against hormone-induced cancers as well as abnormal growth. Cancers include prostate cancer, breast cancer, ovarian cancer, abnormal growth. We include endometriosis, which of course can lead to endometrial cancer as well. Endometriosis is a very interesting area because it's one of the worst health problems for women under 40 in development world.
And preclinical evidence on this front is very encouraging, isn't it? Can you remind us of what you have found out in the preclinical stage?
For endometriosis, we have shown that the compound reduces the endometrial lesions up to at least 50%.
Okay, so what's next on that front then?
Up to that front is we are putting together a proposal for MHRA, who then have a look, but we already have a lot of safety and tolerability data from our prostate cancer drug trial or clinical trials, and that can be used to promote that particular application.
And Satu, in the update, the company says that necessary preparatory steps and conversations are underway. So what can you tell us about the conversations? And are you able to tell us who you are discussing things with and what about?
It's not a secret that a biotech business model is to take things from A to B. And once you start reaching B, which is in our case phase 2 clinical trials, we are starting to talk to big pharmaceutical companies or bigger biotech companies about licensing deals, collaborative deals, and that sort of thing. But I can't give you the names, of course.
No, I understand, obviously. I'd like to move on now to Val-401, your potential treatment for non-small cell lung cancer. Can you tell us about the preparation work you have made for the upcoming phase 2 efficacy study?
We have applied for the said study, and we are waiting for regulatory bodies to come back to us and say what they think. We are very, very positive about that, but of course it needs to go through the ethics committees and all the regulatory committees as the normal drug would do anyway. But we are very, 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 very positive about that.
And you've also filed this second US patent, haven't you, covering the use of Val-401 for a treatment of adenocarcinoma. Can you tell us a bit more about that?
Well, it is the patent protection in US for this particular compound, which is, of course, very valuable. It's one of the biggest markets in the world, as we all know, for these kind of treatments. So having a patent protection there for the next 20 years or whatever is very valuable for the company.
Now, Satu, to wrap up, the company has made good progress in the second quarter. What do you hope to achieve in the third quarter?
We are continuing with Val-201 for efficacy studies, and we will see more efficacy because we are now in a therapeutic level with our clinical studies. And then for 401, we will get into phase 2 clinical studies, and we will announce the results as they come.
Satu, thank you very much for your time. Satu Vainikka, Chief Executive at ValiRx.